Hey guys, you're War Curvers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 local promo where last time I left off. I beat Portsmouth in the Capital One Cup to progress in that competition, and I defeated Sunderland in the league, which led to me going back to the top of the table after Aston Villa defeated Chelsea. So, yeah, I'm back top of the league. Woo! In this episode, I have my second Champions League group stage game against Copenhagen. And I also have a league game against Arsenal. So my first league game against one of the teams that are probably going to be up among the top four, or at least challenging for the top four during the season.
Well, these two teams have already played, of course, on match day one. Now they are involved in this fixture in the Champions Cup match day two.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting one. I think there's improvements to be made from both sides.
Let's do this. Let's see if they can achieve. Yeah, nice early goal. Oh, here's a turbine.
And we put it out here, Alan, as a
four. Get back to the scale. Then. Okay, whip it in again, Matt. Yeah.
Start this way.
This is the Liverpool side.
Just Origi! 1-0. Oh, fantastic.
That's all about anticipation and just
a pressure paid off.
Good luck here again by the replay of the goal.
Two of Copenhagen's players, Tutoa and something else. Someone else. Two of their play. I can't see our guy's name, but all I know is, thanks to them falling over each other, Origi got the ball and he put it in the back of the net. 1-0. Great start. That's the early goal I wanted. For that great save from Drabowski. Sanchez. Can't get the ball I was hoping to play, so I'll play it down this side. Giglio. Come on. Turbe.
A good deal of assists this season, so
again, that's not the pass I was hoping to play. And of course, that's a free kick. Go fuck yourself, referee. Costa. Iheanacho. Brilliant ball to Origi. 1v1. Divock Origi makes it 2-0. Oh. Oh. The Belgian is lethal. In front of goal. Well, and Copenhagen are more than aware of that.
Let's see the replay now. Restarting at 2-0.
Might have taken a slight deflection off the keeper. As it was going in, but they all count, and it's 2-0.
Try, only just over the bar.
Santander. Probably said. Santander. Probably. I'm gonna stop now. The striker for Copenhagen. Blowing it over the bar, wasting his opportunity. Origi won't make that mistake. Oh, but Amati who's playing for Copenhagen, who won't be at Copenhagen next week, of course, signed in real life by Leicester. Which makes me convinced that while Leicester were being saved last season, Claudio Ranieri took some time to play from FIFA 15.
He will be pretty wet after 5 minutes.
And Nacho, great block by the Copenhagen defender.
It's a diagonal ball to switch the play here.
I said this in the last episode, but that passing it around is okay. He went, it's not gonna get you a goal unless you make some progress. So passing it around the back is pretty goddamn pointless. I mean, what's the point of wasting time? Because that's pretty much what you heard. That's the message you relay when you're passing around the back, that you're trying to waste some time. Why would you waste time when at the time there were 2-0 down, now they're 3-0 down, hence that goal from Nacho? Like, why are they trying to waste time? Were they trying to get in to halftime 2 down? Because it didn't work. Seville and Marseille won all. That's the other game in the group stage. If that was to end as it is, that would mean I would have a 2-point lead over Seville going into the third game, which will be against them. It's a bit ironic that I got Seville my
given them a free kick.
Champions League. We got draw. And oh, actually, their game is going to be in the next episode, which will air on Thursday, the day after Liverpool plays Seville in the real-life Europa League final. So, that will be quite interesting. Daniel Motti is in the book. Copenhagen.
Here's the shot.
So, whose shot was blocked? Turbe. Have a go! Oh, what a goal!
And he will not score a better goal than that in his entire career. He's put his foot.
See a few of them in the playoffs, which I've been watching with great interest lately. There was a few really good goals. Was scored in almost. Well, pretty much all of the games I've seen so far had at least one decent goal in them. I'm just glad that I actually saw a goal in the last one that I watched before last night, the Accrington Stanley Wimbledon match. And, well, I'm just thankful that there was an actual goal in that. I was really, it was getting to the point where I was like, oh, there's not going to be a goal in this match. But no, Wimbledon managed to get one. To be fair, Wimbledon should have had a penalty before they scored the goal, so they might have scored anyway had they gotten the penalty. And your man probably should have been sent off because it looked like it. He intentionally tried to block the ball with his hand. And it might have been denying a goal scoring opportunity, which is also calls for a red card. Yeah, big decision that was not given.
That trick hasn't worked against the.
That's football sometimes, but the. Oh, the decision. And I guess Accrington Stanley can thank their lucky stars that it wasn't given. Wimbledon, however, will feel, well, the goal they got was, you know, was like a bit of karma. Because by all right, they could have easily been 1-0 up by then, had they gotten the penalty. Now there's no guarantee they would have scored the penalty.
Be a lapse of concentration to be that far offside.
But anytime you get a penalty, you have a very good chance of scoring it. Unless your penalty taker is awful.
Free kick given.
Unless they do like Liverpool's penalty takers did in the Capital One Cup final and do a stupid, stuttery run up and give the keeper a million chances to save it.
Go back to the goalkeeper here, it does. And in goes the cross. That's a good challenge between the two.
Sometimes that stuttering run-up works, but most of the time, it's just stupid and unnecessary.
Well, we've been locked in this position for a while, for the longest period in the game where the shot's on! Got in and blocked it, Delaney. That's the indication, 4 added minutes.
Anyway, hey, I think that's a... enough of that conversation. Well, me talking about stuff and you guys listening. Obviously, you're not talking. You're like, well, I might get a comment, don't you?
He's got to play it back to the goalkeeper.
And there's the full time whistle. So I am on 6 points. How did Marseille and Seville finish? 2-2. So I am 2 points clear, so I'll be going into that match. Really? Liverpool show? That makes no goddamn sense. The second best player in the world. And I'm showing how good he is? Are you not paying attention in FIFA? No matter which player you sign, it'll always do that if they are in really good form like Ronaldo is, because as you can see, 5 goals clear of both Neymar and Spurs is Chadley. Which is some pretty good damn good form. That's nothing Ronaldo isn't used to. Hell, if anything, that's a slow season for Cristiano Ronaldo. Anyway, and as you can see, I did give Ronaldo the number 7. Here's he, finally.
Cristiano Ronaldo plays up front with Neymar. Referee Kevin Friend.
We gave it to him in the end of the last episode.
Santi Cazorla.
Santi Cazorla. Danny Welbeck, who is now out for a lengthy 9 months.
Marvellous tackle, and Ronaldo.
I'm sure Arsenal fans are cursing that, because that means that they're once again going to be relied on one man and one man only to get all their goals, Olivier Giroud.
Just lost the concentration, lost the ball as well. And they've got to work hard to try and get it back. Alexis Sanchez.
Because Arsene Wenger, as everyone knows, will not sign another striker. Or at least he won't sign a big name striker. He might sign like a young striker with a lot of potential. Well, or maybe he won't send Akpon out alone next season. Whatever he does, it won't be what Arsenal fans want him to do.
That was perhaps the place where it was impossible to save it. No goalkeeper could have reached out. He clips the post on the way in. Yeah, really good.
But Neymar does do what I wanted him to do, and that is open the scoring. That is a fantastic header. Who's actually playing with a Brazilian teammate Coutinho, who's waiting behind him in case Neymar missed. This is header. Now Neymar's only 4 goals behind Cristiano Ronaldo. Bale takes a deflection, but it's in nonetheless. And I think it's gonna go down as Bale's goal. I don't think that's enough. We'll see.
Really digs with his boot at it.
Very clear deflection off 42. Wait, maybe it missed him. It looked like it hit him.
Restarting at 2-0.
Huh. Upon closer inspection, it was hard to this for where it did hit him or not. Let me know in the comment section below, did that take a deflection off Socrates or no?
And that's good support as they build this attack. In goes the tackle and it's a corner.
I'll take the corner.
Coming up again now, Alan. Another look at
Bale's third goal of the season. Here we can tell here. No, still it does. Not very clear. It's going to be an Arsenal throw. I'm not going to make that.
It's gone out off that player there. Theo Walcott. Well, that's a clever little clip into a teammate.
Way! Dumbass.
Royce.
To the man's. Oof. That definitely took a deflection. And made the ball fall very nicely for Paratek. He doesn't need help. I mean, he's a very good goalkeeper.
Gareth Bale. Well, he got away and looked as though he might be in the clear until he was stopped. They will think just about in time.
So hey, another forced error, defensive error from me. The Arsenal are just full of that today. And I do a James Milner special. Can't get a decent corner for going. And then in this occasion. Oh, I'm really glad I missed Santa Cazorla there. That could have been bad. Oh, they're feeling it back to me. Coutinho. Go on, Philippe. Off the post. Coutinho near making a third header on it. Nathaniel Klein. Tillemans. Bell. Back to Tillemans. Alan Largo. Oh. Will someone put the ball in the back of the net, please? Nathaniel Klein. Oh.
That's half time.
I wonder, did Ronaldo jump over because he was offside? Or was there any reason for that at all?
And the referee has blown, and the second half is...
Doesn't really spark me some... And that would make any sort of sense whatsoever.
Mathieu Debuchy. Good hands, bread and butter work really by the goalkeeper.
That's an easy save from my goalkeeper. Laporte. Since Rodriguez on the run. Go. Go Ricardo Rowe. Hello? Yeah, it has to be a yellow card. For Gabriel. Oh. Well, one idiot. Yeah, what was he thinking? Especially when the opposition have Cristiano Ronaldo in the team. Go on, Cristiano. Bitch! Why am I so bad at taking free kicks?
Chewy's manager might have a little quiet word afterwards about that decision.
Okay, if I put... I'll keep attacking on the side Gabriel is on. And maybe he'll fall his way to a red card. Yeah.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Ronaldo.
Santi Cazorla. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain.
Chamberlain for Arsenal. Cazorla.
The attack has done well, beaten his man.
My players are running into each other. The fuck? Great tackle from Tillemans. L. To Tillemans. Play on.
Fine save, he's made that.
Penalty! Oh. That was a half-ass appeal, to be honest. That was never going to be a penalty, the fact that I tripped over Cech as he came to get the ball.
On the EA Sports quick jog of your memory.
10 minutes.
Liverpool, they'll be facing Everton away from home.
Huh. This episode's going to be very interesting, and Merseyside Derby as well.
Deflection.
Is that corner or goal kick? It's a corner.
And the goalkeeper coming off his line.
Easily caught by him, my goalkeeper. Nathaniel Klein.
Neymar.
Neymar.
Well, he's...
Ah! I was hoping he passed it away from Verratti, but no, he passed it straight to him. Good job, Neymar. Good job.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Rodriguez. He's
from midfield after that interception. Danny Welbeck. And here's a chance for Arsenal. Neymar.
Neymar.
Good play, one on one.
Beats everyone. What's Gabriel gonna do? He has to be careful. You have to be careful. Ooh. I thought it was gonna lure him in. Tillemans! Oh man. Wait, I think Arsenal might have just made a substitution. Who went off? I think I saw the thing up in the corner. I didn't catch who came on or went off.
Neymar.
Oh, Mertesacker is on. I'm guessing Gabriel went off. Oh well, I'll take that 3-0. Neymar with his second of the match. 3 points to Liverpool. Yeah, it was Mertesacker for Gabriel. Oh, Wenger. doctor didn't want to see a red card today. Okay. But he put on a slow ass defender who will never ever win in a foot race against a guy like Neymar, and it's 3-0.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
As a matter of fact, if I can... Oh wait, Gabriel is still on. I just saw him. So who did Mertesacker come on for? Because he wasn't on the whole time, so he had to come on for someone. So Arsene Wenger went to 5 at the back. Heck, is that what you're telling me?
That's the decision regarding added time.
Socrates concedes the penalty. It's going to be 4-0 in just a second, and that's probably going to be a yellow card for him. There's Debussy, so it wasn't him. Socrates just committed the foul. I don't think he got a yellow card, though. Speaking of Debussy, just goes off then. He's like, yeah, I was on. Now I'm pissing off. And there's the goal for Ronaldo. Of course he's going to get in on the action. I have to make him the permanent penalty taker, because, you know, Ronaldo. Well, has to live up to one of his more well-known nicknames. 12th goal in the Premier League. This, you know, and just like that, after all Bale, all of Neymar's work to cut the deficit, hit Ronaldo one goal. Oh, half that work. In the blink of an eye. Ah well. I will take it. 4-0. Well, I will definitely take it. Look at that. Everyone's going up. Gomez has gone up to 72. Sanchez has gone up to 71. Pristes goes up to 64. And Fom Itzko Cho, probably pronounced, I'm definitely butchering his name. Oh my gosh. Why does everyone have such impossible to pronounce names? Can't you have a normal name for fuck's sake? Nicholas. I'll just call you Nicholas, okay? Nicholas? Cheers. Actually, I'm gonna take the second gum as train session out. I'm gonna train up Sean here. No smoke without fire for lonely Coutinho. Ah, great. Here we go again. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Lonely? Let's see how lonely he is with 600. Hang on a second. Game doesn't want to play ball. Oh, doesn't know that I can do this. There we go. Offer a new contract. $650, 20% crucial first team player. There is no lonely. Coutinho is fine. He has Neymar, and hell, for Ronaldo speaks Portuguese, because, you know, he is Portuguese. He's... Plus... No. Brito, he's Brazilian, so he speaks it as well. Just sworn I had a nerve. Brazilian. Maybe I'm thinking somebody else. Oh, wait a minute. I'm looking for Roberto Firmino. That's who I'm looking for. He's long gone. Whoops. Oh, well. Oh, look at that. Happy to stay. Hey, so... Oh yeah, you can fuck off. Off with your lonely continual bullshit. Next episode of the Mercy Side, Dark. Hey. Hey. 10 minutes, you were never out of the team. Anyway. Like I was saying, in the next episode I have the Merseyside Derby, and I have the game against Seville. The day after, we play Seville in the Europa League Final. So, will I be trying to avenge a loss us in the Europa League Final, or will I be trying to replicate a great victory? We'll have to wait and see. Either way, it should be fun to do. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very